Good morning, everyone. Today we will continue our chapter 3 of political science of party, and our chapter name is election and representation in India. So today our topic is election commission. We will discuss this topic. Now, composition of election commission. The superintendence, direction and control of the preparation of electoral rolls and conduct all the election to parliament or legislature, legislature of every states, or election to the offices of president, vice president held under this constitution shall be vested in a commission. To assist the election commission of India, there is a chief election officer in every state. The election commission is not responsible for the conduct of local bodies election. The election commission of India can either be a single member or a multi-member body. Till 1989, the election commission was a single member. Just before the 1989, general election means election commissioner were appointed, making the body multi-member. In 1993, two election commissioners were once again appointed, and the commission became multi-member, and it has remained multi-member since then. Now, a multi-member election commission is more appropriate as power is shared and there is a greater accountability they are playing. So, the chief election commissioner presides over the election commission but does not have more powers than the other election commissioners. The chief election commissioner and the two other election commissioners have equal powers to take all the decisions relating to the elections as a collective body. So they all are appointed by the President of India and the advice of the Council of Ministers. The Constitution ensures the security of tenure of the Chief Election Commissioner and the Election Commissioners. They all are appointed for a 6-year term, or continue till the age of 65 years, whichever is earlier. The Chief Election Commissioner can be removed before the expiry of the term by the President if the both House of Parliament make such a recommendation with a special majority. This is done to ensure that a ruling party cannot remove a Chief Election Commissioner who refuses to favor it in elections. Now, our next topic is power and functions of the election commission. We will discuss it. Now, the power and functions of election commissions. Election commission supervise the preparation of up to date of voter list and makes every effort to ensure that the voter list is free or error like non-existence of names of registered voters or existence of names of those of non-eligible or non-existent. Now, determine the timing of elections and prepares the election schedule. The election schedule includes the notification of elections, date from which the nomination can be filled, last date for the filling of nomination, last date for the scrutiny, and last date for the withdrawal or last date of polling and last date of counting and declaration of results. Now, during this entire process, the election commission has the power to take decision to ensure a free and fair election, and it can postpone or cancel the election the entire country or a specific state or constituency on the ground of if the election is not conducted free and fairly. Now, the commission also implemented a model code of conduct for parties and candidates. It can order a re-poll in a specific constituency. It can also order a recount of the votes when it feels that the counting of process it has not been fully fair, it has not been fully fairly. Now, election commission occurs the recognition to political parties and allots the symbol to each of them. So these are the functions and powers of the election commissioner. Now our next topic is suggestions for the electoral reforms. Now what type of suggestions are given for the electoral reforms? Our system of election should be changed for the first past the post system to some variant of the PR system, or means proportional representation system. This would ensure that parties get seats as far as possible in proportion to the votes they get. Now there should be a special provision to ensure that at least 1/3 women are elected to the parliament and assemblies, and there should be a restrictor or provisions to control the role of money in electoral politics. The election expenses should be paid by the government and out of a special fund. Candidate with any criminal cases should be barred from the contesting election, even if their appeal is pending before a court. And there should be a complete ban on the use of caste and religion appeals in the campaigning. And there should be a law to regulate the functioning of political parties and ensure that they function in a transparent and the democratic manner. So these are the suggestion of reforms. Hope it is clear to all. Thank you so much.